IBF, pardon me, International Boxing Hall of Famer Jim Gray.
Get the official decision now as Jake Paul gets his eighth professional win.
Okay, I'll come in the room after.
Just grab the gloves.
You fucking hit him. You got three of them racks. You're fucking doing great. You took back. You gotta keep your hands up though, baby. You need to fucking give me my Muhammad Ali right here. Last minute.
This is good. Down goes Tommy Fury.
Much more aggressive, Silva. This is what you expect. Silva knocked down.
He has done it from time to time. Just haven't been. Oh!
Askin has been hit.
Now, there were moments in the last round where the body work of the legend.
All body right now.
And as usual, with bad intentions, going to the body and the head now.
And then right on the head, right on the temple, and to hit someone on the forehead.
Give him money, Jake. Give him money, Jake. Give him money, Jake.
He's put that pressure on for the first second.
Crouching wildly.
Oh.
Он может опередить.
Plus, IBF, pardon me, International Boxing Hall of Famer Jim Gray.
Let's get the official decision now as Jake Paul gets his eighth professional win.
Okay, I'll come in the room after.
This bout is presented the problem child, Jake Paul.
And the Catskills in Henderson, Nevada, USA. He is from the IBF, Tyson.
All right, gentlemen, I gave you the rules in there. Two legends.
Fight hard, fight clean, touch them up.
Here we go, live.
On the back shots, and get caught with it.
Got it, Joe, got it.
Made a miss.
That's what I'm talking about.
Trying to make him pay. Look at the way he cut the angle on that.
Promising that this one will not.
That was a shot.
Hospital task. The referee will have to
punch volume up again. He's even about the fighter week.
All of what they were in their prime, but Tyson.
I was wondering all week how will come out. Couldn't get a read on the guy.
At the break, this is a grim one out there fighting again. Rebattered him with the right hand to the
butt. Absolutely.
Mike Tyson picking off. Liver and upstairs with that left. Get their mitts. Oh, and there he hosted by Mario Lopez. And what an eclectic team. Use that jab. Keep Tyson at distance. The exhibition is over. Mike Tyson.
Mike wants some more. What it
the
is.
God of War is I've summoned him. Getting Mike frustrated and Mike able to still break loose with his head movement. Miss shots and make him pay. Classic.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a great night of sports and entertainment, courtesy of GES Boxing and Sugar Ray Leonard, and a little help from Mr. Snoop Dogg, plus IBF, pardon me, International Boxing Hall of Famer Jim Gray.
Let's get the official decision now as Jake Paul gets his eighth professional win.
Okay, I'll come in the room after.
Drive the gloves.
I called him that yesterday.
We made for Roy, too.
We were looking for you. We were working your gloves.
Yeah.
We're working for you.
The whole training camp. I called you three times yesterday, man.
You took it. I knew I hit you with a good shot. You took it. I respect that.
Mr. Tyson, what do you think of that?
I'm good with that.
You think you won the fight?
Yeah, but I'm good with a draw.
Why?
Because I entertained the crowd. The crowd was happy with it.
Folks, we have a knockout. Now, here's where it gets juicy. Joe Rogan once said, Mike could finish this fight before we even finish our popcorn. And boy, was he right. I mean, Mike Tyson just sent Jake back to the land of TikTok and YouTube where he belongs. After the fight, Jake's like, I got too comfortable leaning on the ropes. Really, Jake? You thought you were at a beach party instead of a boxing match? It's like he expected to ride out the storm while sipping a cocktail. And let's not forget Tyson's post-fight comment, I felt a bit rusty. Rusty? Come on, Mike. That was like watching a seasoned chef whip up a five-course meal while Jake was still figuring out how to boil water. Let's break down Jake's style for a second. I mean, the kid has heart. I'll give him that, but his punches looked more like enthusiastic slaps than anything resembling technique. And when he gets backed into a corner, it's like watching a deer caught in headlights. Now Mike, on the other hand, he's a monster. Every punch he throws is like a freight train coming at you. He's got that head movement, the footwork, the ability to read his opponent. Honestly, watching him is like watching a master painter at work if the canvas was Jake's face. The aftermath of this fight was nothing short of hilarious. Social media exploded. Memes of Jake's knockout were everywhere. Did you see that uppercut? It was trending like it was the hottest gossip on the block. You'd think the world just witnessed the second coming of Christ.
He's undefeated in his young campaign to the squared circle. The popular media sensation and the undefeated boxer known as Jake Paul.
Okay, you're gonna beat this kid, Jake Paul?
Very badly.
Promising that this one will not.
That was a shot.
That was a shot. pivotal task. The referee,
this man on the planet.
Jake is done. Well, he's punches and bunches. He throws missiles, not just one bomb, freaking one after the other. Cuss would say he moved his head so great, the guy couldn't hit him with a machine gun.
Hey, listen, nobody's a perfect expert with two people in the ring. Anything can happen, destiny's involved.
I don't look at this like it's going to be easy fight. This guy's going to be prepared. I'm prepared for it. I'm training extremely hard, yeah. Well, I like him, but in this particular fight, he has to go. I started Jake Paul off. On my fight with Roy Jones, I allowed him to fight on the card, and I decided I started him, and I'm going to finish him. I don't look at myself as a middle-aged man. I feel really good. I mean, when you're in the top physical and spiritual shape, you hear and notice everything. Highest form of relaxation.
You'd fight Tyson Fury.
Yeah, I'd fight a lion if the price is right.
How about me and Mike?
Water, they would say it's because I couldn't swim. And this is to make history. You know, if people think I'm gonna get knocked out by this strong, powerful guy, all the people in my comments saying, look at his power, he's gonna get KO'd. People are yelling at me in the event. But what happens when I put this man to sleep? This shit is not a joke. He's saying that it's gonna be my funeral. He's saying it's gonna be my wake. He's gonna kill Jake Paul, all of these things. And that's why I love Mike, I respect him, but we're not friends anymore. Until November 15th, I'm knocking this motherfucker out and we're gonna see who's dead.
Well, I commend Tyson, because he's one of the guys that paved the way for me to be where I'm at. You know, he's a legendary champion. And the only thing I have to say about Mike Tyson is everyone is always trying to judge Mike Tyson. He lived his life the way he wanted to live.
58-year-old men are 58-year-old men, no matter what they look like. Right. And Jake Paul is a 28-year-old athlete in the...
So, let's see what this press conference delivers. We know the fight is a joke.
Well, I commend Tyson, because he's one of the guys that paved the way for me to be where I'm at. You know, he's a legendary champion. And the only thing I have to say about Mike Tyson is everyone is always trying to judge Mike Tyson. He lived his life the way he wanted to live.
And I'm happy that I was able to the ring with so many legendary fighters. You know, to become a great fighter, you had to become great, you had to fight great fighters, you had to fight good fighters. So I wouldn't be where I'm at if it wasn't for the certain guys that paved the way for me today.
58-year-old men are 58-year-old men, no matter what they look like. Right. And Jake Paul is a 28-year-old athlete in the prime of his life.
I'm beautiful, and I've been training for a while, like 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
I'm just asking when you get into camp.
I'm okay to fight.
But when you get into camp, like when?
I'm in camp right now.
Very good, thank you.
I'm in camp right now.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
I love you, Mike.
Same.
And I'm very nervous for you.
Thank you. I care.
I do care. I care about you. And I care about my brother. And I know the path he's on right now. And it's ruthless, Mike.
I agree. It's pretty cool.
It's cool. It's so cool to watch. And he's really crushing it. And I just feel like I want you to be okay in there, Mike.
Today we're diving into a matchup that has the internet buzzing like a beehive on caffeine Mike Tyson BS. Jake Paul. Yes, you heard it right. The man who once made opponents question their life choices is now set to throw down with the YouTube star turned wannabe boxer. Buckle up, because this is going to be a wild ride filled with sarcasm, excitement, and a dash of disbelief. All right, let's kick things off with a quote from the man himself, Mike Tyson. He's been in the spotlight, doing interviews and sharing his thoughts about the upcoming fight. And let me tell you, it's both hilarious and intimidating at the same time.
Okay, you're gonna beat this kid, Jake Paul?
Very badly.
Here's what he had to say. Okay, you're going to beat this kid Jake Paul very badly. I don't look at this like it's going to be an easy fight. This guy is going to be prepared. I'm not, but I'm prepared for it. Training extremely hard. Now, let's pause right there. First off, did Mike just admit he's not prepared? I mean, this is the same guy who once said he'd fight anyone, anywhere, anytime. But sure, let's be honest about it, Mike. Meanwhile, he's out here training harder than ever. This kid Jake Paul better watch out. Iron Mike is coming in hot. Then Mike adds, yeah, well, I like him. But in this particular fight, he has to go. Now, hold on a second. Mike, you like him? Are we sure you're not talking about your pet tiger from back in the day? Because, honestly, there's nothing about Jake Paul that screams likable in a boxing ring. This is a guy who made his name on YouTube, and now thinks he can take on one of the most fearsome fighters in history. You have to admire the audacity, though. I mean, who doesn't love a good underdog story? Tyson continues, I started Jake Paul off on my fight with Roy Jones. I allowed him to fight on the card, and I decided to start him, and I'm going to finish him. Wow, Mike. You're like the father figure of boxing grooming little Jake for this moment. But really, finish him? I can already picture it, Jake, with his big dreams of being a champion, realizing he's in way over his head. It's like watching a toddler try to ride a bike without training wheels. Spoiler alert, it doesn't end well. Then there's this gem, I don't look at myself as a middle-aged man. I feel really good when you're in the top physical and spiritual shape. I mean, that's great, Mike. But I also don't think anyone's questioning your physical shape. You're Mike Tyson. You could probably still knock out a grizzly bear. Meanwhile, Jake Paul is out here flexing for Instagram like he's on a tropical vacation, thinking that'll help him in the ring. Spoiler alert, it won't. Tyson goes on to say, hey, listen, nobody's a perfect expert with two people in the ring. Anything can happen. Destiny's involved. Ah, yes, destiny. That magical force that we all hope is on our side during a big fight. But let's be real, unless destiny is packing a punch, it's not going to help Jake here. This isn't some fairy tale where the underdog magically rises to the occasion. This is a boxing match against one of the most feared fighters in history.
Well, you'd fight Tyson Fury.
Yeah, I'll fight a lion if the price is right.
How about me and Mike?
Then we get to the juicy part. Tyson responds to a question about fighting Tyson Fury. Yeah, I'll fight a lion if the price is right. Can we take a moment to appreciate that response? A lion? Seriously, Mike? At this point, it feels like he's just daring anyone to step up. Come at me, bro. It's like he's challenging the universe itself. Meanwhile, Jake is just trying to figure out how to stay upright in the ring. And then Tyson nails it with this line. All he does is throw punches in bunches. He throws missiles, not just one bomb. Freaking one after the other. Wow, Mike. A metaphor for Jake's boxing style or just a savage roast. Because let's be honest, Jake's punches look more like they belong in a toddler's boxing match than in the squared circle with Iron Mike. And let's not forget Tyson once knocked out opponents with a single blow. Tyson's confidence is palpable. Coos would say he moved his head so great the guy couldn't hit him with a machine gun. Ah, Coos D'Amato. If he could see Tyson now, I bet he'd be shaking his head in disbelief at the thought of Jake Paul stepping into the ring with his prodigy. I mean, come on. Do people forget who Iron Mike Tyson is? He's a savage who used to play with full-grown tigers. This isn't just a man, this is a legend with a legacy. And he's ready to add Jake Paul's name to the list of people he's knocked out. Now, after all that hype, I've got to ask, are you as hyped as I am to see Jake Paul get flattened? Hit like if you're ready for the show, and let's hear your thoughts in the comments. Do you think Mike stands a chance against today's top heavyweights? Because if he can knock out a social media star with one punch, I think he's got a shot. So here we are, folks, leading up to what could be one of the biggest moments in boxing history. Picture this, the lights dim, the crowd roars, and in one corner, we have Mike Tyson, Iron Mike himself, the man, the myth, the legend. And in the other corner, we have Jake Paul, the self-proclaimed problem child who has somehow convinced himself that he can take on the heavyweight king. Let's break this down. Betting odds aside, it feels like an adult versus a child in this matchup. The last time I checked, Mike Tyson could probably knock Jake out with a single sneeze, but here we are. The kid is strutting around like he owns the place, probably thinking he's going to pull off an upset. As we approach fight night, I can only imagine what it's going to be like in the arena. Will Jake come in with his usual bravado, or will he finally realize he's outmatched? I can see the commentators now, struggling to find words to describe the impending destruction. Let's talk about the press conference. You know it's going to be gold. Jake will probably try to trash talk, throwing out lines like, I'm going to beat the legendary Mike Tyson, while Mike just sits there smirking like he's heard this all before. I mean, come on. He's not just a fighter, he's a living legend. And once the dust settles and the smoke clears, what will we say? Will we see a humbled Jake Paul, licking his wounds and realizing that maybe he should stick to YouTube? Or will we witness a resurgent Mike Tyson, ready to take on whatever comes next in his storied career? One thing is for sure, Mike Tyson's legacy is already cemented in history. Whether he wins or loses against Jake, he's still Iron Mike. Meanwhile, Jake is still trying to figure out how to tie his boxing gloves. The real question is, can Mike capitalize on this opportunity to remind everyone why he's still a force to be reckoned with? As we gear up for this epic showdown, remember to keep your popcorn ready and your opinions flowing. I want to hear from you. Do you think Jake stands a chance, or is Mike going to show him what it means to step into the ring with a real heavyweight? Let's get those comments rolling. And that's a wrap for today, folks. Thanks for tuning in. Until next time, keep your gloves up and your sarcasm sharper than ever.
One of the most devastating heavyweight KO punchers of all times, Iron Mike Tyson.
Count to 10, y'all two with the judges. Let's touch them up. Rook, when are you ready? Buck!
And we've had an accidental headbutt, I heard.
Jake Paul seems pretty relaxed, okay, because yeah. I'm like, hey, you came running.
I don't want any more of this.
My uncle is out there fighting right now.
Yeah.
You still got it?
Well, there's a double, triple jab with Mike Tyson.
He does.
Referee encouraging them. Two legends left.
Must be a round.
Hostile task. The referee will have to really be on the...
I like a body. That left hook kind of landed.
That was a shot.
Right hand, maybe the side of the back, straight fall up.
Oh, right hand, the body, another hip up. OG Snoop Dogg, and look at this.
Nice combination.
I'm a little bit.
Uppercut from Jake Paul. Back
too slow on his feet. Well, he was already cut up right there.
Yeah, that was
nice 1-2 there. That was a solid 1-2 by.
Ford remains. Rounds.
More so, Willie just doesn't seem comfortable in there. Took a right hand from
liver and upstairs with that left hook, and there's a little of that bobbing weaving, of course.
Good exchange there in the inside. That was pretty good uppercut, but that was pretty
up and not take no big hits, but keep it in tight like that.
But is it entertaining and exciting for?
He can't let Mike get...